How are you? Well, hello there, Malt Muzzles. Ralphie here, and thank you to Florence for that malty mention. And welcome to Whisky Review. I was about to say Rum Review because I'm reviewing a rum, but I'm still Whisky Reviews, you know. That's our main gig, you know. And it's Whisky Review 188. And of course, we're reviewing a rum. It's part of our little rum series, recommended, Ralphie's recommended rums. And we're continuing with a rum that we first encountered in Whisky Review 186B. And it was at Dave Broom's Rum Chapel at the Edinburgh Whisky Fringe, organised very professionally by royalmilewhiskies.com. Go and check out their website. They've got a good range of stuff, including rums. Even if you're not buying, if you happen to be another country, it's always worth looking at online spirit shops, whisky, rum, whatever, in other countries to see what other countries have got, because it might be coming into your country, or you might have someone going over on holiday who can pick you up a bottle, probably at a better price if you're lucky. And talking of prices, there's prices still on the screw top. And I did mention in the last review, I believe, that screw tops... No, I didn't actually. I'd actually started recording the previous review, 187, and then the batteries ran out as I was talking, so I completely changed the script when I was re-recording it. And I did mention, and I'll mention it now, if you are buying spirits, do not be put off by screw tops. I know that corks are posh and classy, and that's why corks are primarily used in single malt whiskies and many rums and tequilas and stuff. But let me assure you that some of the finest single malts ever bottled had screw tops or wee flick-up wire tops. It doesn't diminish the quality in any way at all. And if you're going to keep a screw top bottle as a collector's item, if it's really important to you and you're worried about evaporation, very easy remedy: put some wee plastic bag or some cling film over the top of the neck of the bottle and tie some string round it. But there's really no need for that. The important thing is, don't lay it on its side. And I'll tell you why, because there's a wee bit of cardboard up there, waxed cardboard that provides the seal, and the alcohol will get into that cardboard and deteriorate it, then you will have leaks. Anyway, I'm about to leak some of this rum into this glass here, as I do quite often. Wonderful stuff. It was Dave Broom who recommended this, and I tasted this first at his rum chapel. And I thought it was excellent. I thought it was fascinating because apparently this is a single cask rum that has been matured in an ex-whisky cask. Now, occasionally you'll find this, that the whisky industry regularly use rum casks for maturing whisky. Good example is the Glenfiddich 21-year-old reserve, originally called Havana Reserve, until American embargoes put the kibosh in that. But there are certainly Springbank have done some really good Springbanks matured in rum casks. Some single malts really latch on to the sweetness and the syrupiness of the rum. And it works the other way around, as it does with this. A rum matured in a whiskey cask, and it's gaining some of that whiskey fruitiness that balances off against the rum sweetness and molasses nature. This is from Barbados, Foursquare Distillery. They do a very good spiced rum, highly recommended by Dave Broom, although personally I think the Elements 8 spiced rum is a little bit better. Not a lot, just a bit. It's got some information on the label, useful information. Bottled at 40% alcohol, should have been 46. Should have been 46 Foursquare, but it doesn't seem by the haziness in it to have been particularly chill filtered. Excellent stuff. Now, where's my magnifying glass? I always forget my reading glasses. 1998 vintage, an exceptional cask selection, blah blah. Aged for 10 years in cask number 2807, bottled in July 2008 from a bourbon cask. I'll hold it up, let you see it. There it is. It's got a wee bit of blurb in the back. What I can tell you, sticking my nose in this, it's very well done. Very well. Whoever has created this cask of single cask rum is very experienced and certainly knows what they are doing. The balance is excellent. The integration of the influences balancing each other off without any particular one dominating too much is very good indeed. Where are my notes? Just before I read my notes, just a wee bit of information on Foursquare Rum from Barbados. As Dave Broom mentioned, Barbados or Bajan Rum lies right in the middle of the rum range, with a lighter style found from the likes of Trinidad and the heavy style found from Jamaica. Multiple column stills operating, and I noted this down, it's slightly below atmospheric pressure, because rather like a pressure cooker, if you kind of bring the pressure down, things basically cook a bit quicker. And apparently that's what they're doing at Foursquare Distillery, because it saves in energy, but also importantly, if you are distilling at a slightly lower temperature due to a partial vacuum in your stills, you're actually stopping the heat denaturing the flavours. So you actually get more of a kind of fresher flavour from your resultant spirit. There you go. And yes, blah blah, very professional. Fine. Let's have a look at my tasting notes. Complex fruitiness. It has that spicy sweetness that I've really noticed in the likes of Mount Gay, which is the oldest distillery in Barbados. And I'm getting wee hints of different fruits here. Cherry, apricot, cranberry, and there's certainly kind of a slightly acetone honey. I'd call it Jamaica honey. It doesn't smell sugary. It doesn't immediately smell sugar cane-ish. The taste, again, reminding me of Jamaica, particularly Hampden Distillery in Jamaica, a kind of real super ripe, almost slightly rotting bananas, super fruit nature. Soft honey with mixed dried fruit, including apricot, banana and sultanas. There's clove and cinnamon spices come through once you add a drop of water. And also a touch of rather interesting menthol. The water, you know, like cough sweets, the wee touch of that, it's just in the background and it's lovely. The water lifts and softens the slightly Jamaica character of this, that acetone, aldehyde nature that you get particularly from Ray and Nephew Overproof. Now that is one belt of a rum. And my notes say, this rum matured in whiskey cask, double matured 8 years in one cask and then re-racked into other casks for the remainder of its maturation into the whiskey casks. It seems to be a single cask, but not confirmed in the bottle. And the weakness, if there's any weakness to be found, it is slightly flattens in the finish. For such a big arrival and development, the finish isn't as full. I'd put a finish in this. I'm really tempted with this one to add a couple of drops and just a drop of Ardbeg. I think that would take this rum to very interesting places. There we go. This is still out there, bearing in mind it is apparently a single cask. I'm sure there will be others. This has been successful. It is Ralphie recommended. 88 out of 100. It's a rum mark from Ralphie.com. That's me. And there you go. Thank you very much for watching. Come back shortly and I'll review some more rums. Yippee!